Welcome to the Radio Vault Mystery Theater. I am the keeper of the vault. We all have ideas about what perfection is. What is just right to some is dreadfully wrong to others. This seems to be most evident when it comes to artistic opinion. Our story tonight is Carolina Crooners. Act 1. Harley Marks sat at what used to be the stage of the greatest jazz joint on the East Coast, in Wilmington, North Carolina. The Seabreeze Club. The fire had left only charred remains of what had been the most magnificent venue that he'd ever performed on. The rumor was it was a former headliner that had lost his mind when Harley had performed his favorite song. All that swank decor made easy kindling, and the club had gone up like a Roman candle. All that was left was echoes of old times.
Ah, yes, my old home, the Seabreeze Club. How magnificent it used to be here. Everything so swank and swell. Ah, the ladies, how they'd swoon when I sang to them. They loved my velvet crooning. Too bad it had to come to an end. It's a shame that someone could let bitterness and jealousy get the better of them, to the point of destroying this amazing venue. That Jerry Jenkins just couldn't get over it that I was a better crooner, that I filled seats better than he did. I guess he really lost it, though, when the ladies started swooning over my version of his favorite song. I remember singing I'll Never Smile Again by Ruth Lowe. She'd written it for her husband who passed away. Such a sad, melancholy song. I could almost hear the heartbeats of the audience when I sang to them. The silence was so complete, so serene. I'll never smile again until I smile at you. I'll never laugh again. What good would it do? But alas, it will never be the same again. Then there's this place, the new Seabreeze Club. This Ben Adams guy, what does he know about building a classy joint? Apparently nothing. What a joke. These curtains, what crap material. Probably Japanese. He's probably one of those guys who wants to make a fast buck and doesn't really care about real class.
I don't think you know what you're talking about. I'm in the middle of telling a story. Go away.
Pardon the intrusion, please. End of Act 1. And now, Act 2. Ben Adams sat in his office at the end of a long day of auditions for the vocalist of his soon-to-be-opening club. It had been grueling. He had heard some that were incredibly good, some not so good, but none of them seemed to be the right fit for his new club.
Whoa, what a day. All these crooners. None of them have the same sound as Harley Marks or Tony Martin. Some are good, just none of them seem to be just right. You know, maybe I'll take a ride over to the club, see if I can find a little energy. I've about gone broke on this project. You know, I don't regret putting so much money into it, though. Only the best for the new Seabreeze Club. The original one was the crown jewel of the coast. Anything less would be disparaging to the name itself.
Ben drove into the night with sounds of swing music playing on his car radio. He pulls into the parking lot of the new club that had been where the original club stood before it had burned down during Harley Marx's performance in 1946. He smiled to himself briefly before getting out and heading to the new building. Harley's spirit moved in close behind.
Wow, I sure hope I can get some of the generation of techno thumpers to appreciate the amazing music that came out of this era.
You called this a stage?
I can almost see Harley Marx standing on the stage.
You couldn't pay me enough to sing here. What a dump.
I hope some of the old-timers here in Wilmington appreciate the attention to detail I put into this.
Oh, brother. Give me a break. This guy really has no clue what class is.
I wish Mom and Dad were here to see this. We open in a few weeks. They were the ones who gave me the love for this.
Did you want to make them cry?
Well, I'm taking a real gamble here. Just hope we can cover the bills for the first couple of years.
Good luck on that.
Hello?
Go away.
Hi there. We won't be opening for about a month, 6 weeks. Sorry.
Hello. My name is Tara Mills. I know, well, you see, well, I heard you're having auditions for a lead vocalist in a big band group.
Oh, I'm sorry. The auditions were at my office earlier today and are closed.
Please. I know the auditions were earlier, but I couldn't get off work. I went to your office and saw that it was closed. So I took a chance to see if you might be willing to let me audition.
I'm sorry you wasted your time, but the auditions are closed.
Mr. Adams, I beg of you to just hear me. I love this type of music and have been singing it all my life.
Well, it's too bad you missed the auditions then. The answer is still no.
End of Act Two. And now, a word from our sponsor.
In his spare time, he sits alone at a well-known diner, waiting to be discovered. He has a check made out to himself for $1 million, since that's how Jim Carrey did it. Disney is on his resume because he once visited the theme park. He thinks that having his picture taken with someone famous makes him famous. The phrase, "it's all about who you know," doesn't apply to him, as he doesn't know anybody. He truly believes that if only Johnny Depp hadn't been cast, the role would have been his. He knows that once he upgrades his home studio, his booking ratio will skyrocket. His agent charges him a monthly fee and won't admit to knowing him. When competing for a job, he takes advice from his competitors. After paying thousands of dollars to discover his brand, he found out it was Wonder Bread. He's positive that his complete lack of training is offset by his overabundance of raw talent. If he's chosen in the top three, it's because he's the only one who auditioned. He is the least interesting actor in the world.
I don't ever get cast, but I can quote you statistics on all of my failures.
And now, Act 3. Tara started for the door with her head down. Suddenly she stopped, turned around, and started to sing.
Until I smile at you, I'll never laugh again. What good would it do?
Stop.
I'm sorry. It was a song written by a woman, and it is famous for a man singing it. I love the song so much. It's kind of how I feel now.
Too bad, Dame. It is a song meant for a man to sing, not a woman.
Are you kidding me? That was the most amazing sound I've heard all day.
Wait a minute. What?
I was thinking of a man, or at least I was thinking more along the lines of a crooner. I'd be a fool to let you get away, though.
Well, most of the time when people think of crooners today, they think of a man. But there were lady crooners, too. But there was Dinah Shore, Judy Garland, and Ella Fitzgerald. They were all considered crooners.
I'm going back to my office. I hope you'll meet me there so you can sign a contract with me to headline at my club when it opens. I'm canceling all the callbacks.
I'll meet you there.
There's your copy. Glad to have you with us. Rehearsal with the band starts Monday at 6. Be there.
Count on it.
Harley sat on the charred remains of the stage of the old nightclub. He was furious about being replaced by a woman. But to add insult to injury, she was singing his favorite song. He couldn't let this happen. With evil intentions, Harvey decided to attend Monday's rehearsal. After everyone became acquainted, the rehearsal began.
Okay, everyone, let's run through the first one a couple times with just the instrumental part. Then we'll have Tara join in.
I can't stand to hear this. I gotta get some air. Is on the marquee. I can't take this. Time to lock it down.
This was the stage where I was supposed to perform. I make sure that no one can ever perform again.
No one would ever build on the site where the Seabreeze Club stood twice, lest they incur the wrath of the Carolina Crooners. Carolina Crooners is a production of Troop of Lost Souls Entertainment and Film Syndicate, written by Charlie Mitchell, produced by Anthony Stapiello, and directed by Rick L. Baker. Post-production and sound effects by Brian Collins. Commercials by Joe J. Thomas. Video post by Naruko Ito. The cast was played by Joe J. Thomas as Harley Marks, Anthony McCarthy as Ben Adams, Catherine Natelli as Tara Mills, and I am Trevor Bates, your psychotic storyteller and keeper of the vault. Remember, comment, share, like, and subscribe. Thank you. Tune in next week and listen if you dare.